In this paper, we work with a very interesting material, silk-based materials. These are natural fibers that, humans have been using for thousands of years because of their unique properties, their unique luster and lightweight and pleasant feel. So they've been used for textiles for a long time. But there's a lot more to silk fibers than just their use for textiles. More recently, we've started to recognize the unique biocompatibility and biodegradable properties of these materials, and that opened the door for many biomedical applications. But the issue is that if we want to use silk materials for biomedical applications, we don't want it to be in the form of fibers, but rather in the forms of films that exhibit interesting optical, mechanical, and electrical properties. So in this paper, we work on developing regenerated silk fibroin films, which are optically transparent and mechanically flexible, based on processing of these natural fibers along with carbon nanotubes, where we leverage the interactions between the carbon nanotubes and the silk fibroids combined with microwave heating and solvent annealing in order to tune their properties.
Silk fibroin is mainly composed of two kinds of amino acids, glycine and alanine, up to 75%. And the high content of these two amino acids result in the highly conserved protein sequence, such as glycine, alanine, like this. And this conserved protein sequence prefers to form a beta sheath structure by hydrogen bonding between the protein molecules. And this beta sheath structure leads to the exceptional mechanical property of natural silk fiber. However, during the regeneration process, the beta sheath structure turns into output tissue. So it is very important to controlling the secondary structure of regenerated silk fibroin, such as alpha helix or beta sheath structure, in order to controlling the water property of regenerated silk fibroin.
After the silk regeneration process, the resulting films are amorphous and highly transparent in water. This is why we need post-processing methods to induce the formation of secondary structures, such as alpha helix and beta sheets, which usually exhibit better mechanical and regulation properties. These methods include exposing the silk fibroin to solvents in vapor or liquid form to induce the secondary structures in a process known as solvent annealing. Alternatively, we can use heating to induce the secondary structures in a process known as thermal annealing. We can also use additives such as glycerol, which has been shown to induce alpha-rich structures in the silk matrix.
We added surface functionalized carbon nanotubes into silk fibroin matrix during the regeneration process. And after preparation of the composite film, we used microwave irradiation for the local heating of silk molecules nearby CNTs using the differences of electroconductivity between the CNT and silk fibroin. And we confirmed that the local heating of silk molecules resulted in local crystallization. So we further investigated the effect of local crystallization on the material profile of regenerative silk composite films.
Our films exhibited enhanced water degradation and tunable mechanical properties. The films also exhibited enhanced mechanical properties, like 90% increase in mechanical strength and an 80% increase in elongation, owing to the synergetic CNT reinforcement effects and the ductile properties of the alpha helix-rich structure. The mechanical and optical properties of our films are comparable to synthetic polymers such as BET, with the added advantage of better sustainability and biocompatibility as well.
Our work enables a high degree of tunability of the structure and properties of the regenerated silk fibroin films, and we're excited about taking this further in the future and developing both the science and technology aspects of creating these functional materials. So there is, from a scientific perspective, there is a lot more to do in order to understand the interactions between the nanotubes, the functionalization of the nanotube surfaces with the protein molecules. And from a technological perspective, from an engineering perspective, we want to develop the process, the manufacturing process for taking these cocoons of natural silk fibers and transform them into a functional, thin, transparent, flexible materials that are useful for many applications such as flexible electronics, including sensors and memory devices.